an important question indeed, because the church needs priests and religious brothers, sisters, monks, nuns, although the lay people are 99.9% of the church. Vocations to the priesthood and religious life, there are many ways to discern. That means to try to find out the will of God for this person. Prayer, examine the person's talents, health, what the person can do or not do, advice. They will have to go to wise people who know about seminaries, in this case, vocations director, maybe your pastor, maybe the bishop's co-workers in this area to advise the person. Some monasteries, how they do vocations is, for instance, the Clarissons here, if you, a girl wants to join them, they invite her to read about them, to come and live with them for 1 week or 2 weeks, and then go home, reflect, pray, consult, until finally God's grace and the person's cooperation open the way. If you ask me, how was my own done? Finally, only divine providence knows how he guides each one. But the best example for us is if you have a priest or a religious sister or brother who is a model, then they can inspire young people to be like them. In my own case, we had a priest who was a model. The first priest I ever knew, Father Cyprian Michael, he went and danced. And he baptized me, he gave me first confession, first communion. I was his mass server in 1945. He was such an exceptional figure that many young boys wanted to be like him. So he inspired me to go to the seminary. Actually, he has been beatified, and John Paul II, now saint, flew to Nigeria just to perform the ceremony of beatification of my master in 1998. I returned to Rome 3 days, the Pope did. After that, I was ready to sing with Simeon, "Lord, you can dismiss your servant in peace, because my master is now in the headquarters in heaven." So these are elements that help us, other human beings. When I was an archbishop in the diocese, I went around the parishes, and I would always ask the priest, "How many seminarians from your parish?" If he said, 2, 3, I said, "Why? But there are many boys here. Maybe you are not an exemplary priest. That's why nobody likes to be like you." through your most grievous fault. If you have sisters like Mother Teresa of Calcutta, many would like to be like her. Mother Teresa of Calcutta, her life was very hard. In their congregation, the missionaries of charity, they have only 3 habits. 3. No sister will have more than 3. They have the same knife, fork, plate, enamel, and bucket. When they are transferred, they take them to the next house. I asked Mother Teresa once, "Why do many congregations of sisters not have many vocations today?" Her answer was worthy of a saint. She said, "I do not know, because I have not met that problem." That means my congregation has many members. If some congregation don't have, let them ask themselves questions. You must have heard of Bishop Brooklyn Lincoln, and the Dominican sisters of Nashville are famous in the United States, that they always have vocations. Why? It is very interesting. I do not say through your fault, through your most grievous fault, always. But sometimes it is our fault that we don't have enough candidates. It may be the fault of the family, it may be the fault of the newspapers and the television, which orient the young people in the wrong way, the whole society being materialistic, hedonistic, pleasure loving. Nobody wants to make any vow valid for 10 years. Even some young people don't want to marry. They just stay together. They don't want to bind themselves by any vow that will bind them for their whole life. Then such a mentality will not like to be a seminarian. I think that enough is enough. Thank you.
Thank you.